July, Mount Hutt, one of New Zealand's newest ski fields. Six skiers, five New Zealanders, one American. A team, back home to demonstrate and compete in a new approach to competitive skiing. Freestyle. First of three freestyle forms. Freestyle began as an exuberant reaction to the constraints of conventional skiing. Now it has stretched the limits of what's possible on skis. August, Coronet Peak. This year, Coronet Peak, above New Zealand's largest ski resort, Queenstown, is the scene of the National Freestyle Championships. For the team, a return to a ski field much grown since last they were here, as well as a chance to test new skills against old adversaries. Jump is built. The team prepare for competition. They're joined by an old friend, Randy Wieman, holder of the European Freestyle Cup.
That was a good one, huh? Mm. See that one?
Right.
40 feet in
time. Why didn't you do that intro?
Right, Wieman. I'll come over to the flip zone over here.
Just hold it, Lynn.
The jumps. Like all freestyle, an extension of a more formalized traditional skiing. It's not how far you jump that counts, but what you can do in the air. It's judged on style and degree of difficulty. It's also more dangerous.
Oh, oh,
no.
Third freestyle form. Again, it's not altogether how fast you do it, but how much you can do when you do it.
Maybe a boy to watch out for.
And again, madness helps. Competition over and prizes won. There remains one last challenge before the season ends: to ski a live volcano.
No, it's volcanic, you know.
Oh, isn't worth taking a Billy?
A Billy?
September, Mount Narahoe. One of the three great skiable volcanoes in the North Island. But unlike the others, this one is alive and thus undeveloped. So, once you're there, you can realize a dream. To have the mountain all to yourself.
Well, that's a real experience.